Don't you always want to be the best you can be?
The Frankie Boyer Show.
What is this?
It's more than a lifestyle show.
It's a show about living in today's world.
I think something is happening.
Frankie enthusiastically brings an amazing eclectic mix to the airwaves.
You got that right.
One of the reasons she's earned legions of loyal fans is very simple. When you listen to the Frankie Boyer Show, you just never know what's going to happen next.
So listen for yourself.
Here is Frankie Boyer.
And welcome. It is so nice to have you with us. This is Frankie Boyer, and you're listening to us on Biz Talk Radio, biztalkradio.com. And this is the Friday edition of the Frankie Boyer Show here on Biz Talk, which means it's time for Cannabis Talk A to Z with Frankie Boyer. This is a journey that I embarked on several months ago to bring information, cutting-edge information, just information and education, because there's so much that we don't know about this green world, whether it be cannabis or CBDs. There's so much unknown, and we are piling through all of the material. We're trying to really uncover layer by layer, piece by piece, to understand that this movement is not going away. And there are many varieties of products and people to help with a plethora of problems that our country is having. And so I hope you understand that this is not about, and I say this because if you want to go in a room and pass a joint around, good for you, go for it. But that's not what this show is about. This is not the purpose of this program. So without further ado, to continue on our educational theme, we have invited Dean Petkanis to the show. He is CEO of Cannalife Sciences, and his company is doing some exciting research. This is the kind of information that we don't hear about in the news every day, but we need to. And so, Dean, what a pleasure. Welcome to the program, and tell us a little bit about your background and how you got into Cannalife and all of the different pieces behind it.
Thanks for having me, Frankie. I appreciate the time. I started working in plant-based medicines long before the movement in cannabis as a medicament became popularized. Somewhat back in 1992, I involved myself in a pharmaceutical startup that was involved in making an anti-cancer drug. And that anti-cancer drug came from the bark of the Pacific yew tree. It's now known as Taxol. With that, I was kind of stoked with a lot of knowledge that much of what we see in today's medical corridors is medicine that's based originally from some plant source. And then it possibly synthesized, semi-synthesized, compounded, and put into a dose-dependent form for treatment. So sometime in 2009, many years after the fact, of course, of my experience in both an anti-cancer agent and also in a sickle cell drug, I turned my attention to the medical marijuana markets. Truth be known, I was drawn to it by a business partner of mine who wanted to be in dispensing and growing, and I wanted to have nothing to do with that. I cited many inefficiencies that were waiting for the marketplace. So it's like jumping into a swimming pool without any water, blindfolded. And I really didn't want to go into those areas for many reasons, notwithstanding the economic burdens that would come down the pike. But instead, I took my base of knowledge in plant-based medicine, and I brought it forward, theorizing that at some point, to rationalize cannabinoid therapeutics, as a cannabinoid that comes from a cannabis or a hemp plant, and then it's purified and turned into a drug, or as an active pharmaceutical ingredient, one would have to start from that point moving forward and dedicate oneself to the pharmaceutical side of it. You know, in some areas, cannabis activists decry the evils of pharmaceuticals, but the reality is that pharmaceutical companies...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.